Hey guys, Hackersploit here, back again with another video. In this video, I'm going to be showing you some of the best ways you can actually learn Linux if you're a beginner. If you already have experience with Linux, this is a great way of actually validating your skills and also sharpening them, making sure that everything's, the way it should be, so to say. So why am I making these types of videos? We've been getting a lot of comments telling me, yeah, why are you making these types of videos? These are not technical enough. Well, as I said, one of the reasons why I'm making these videos is primarily because I get asked these questions quite a bit. One of the questions is, how do I learn Linux? There's tons of resources out there, but what's the best way to learn Linux? I'm a beginner to cybersecurity. Do I need to know Linux? The answer is yes, you need to know Linux because you are going to be using Linux utilities. And to answer your question, I would have answered this question a year ago by saying just install Linux and use it as your primary operating system or your daily driver, and that would offer you a good starting point to actually learning about the system, doing a lot of things. But I understand that that's not a that vague answer is not going to cut it. Primarily because the thing that I like doing on this channel the most is sort of helping you not make stupid mistakes. One of the dumbest mistakes you can make is use an operating system and think you know everything about it. And of course, I'm not assuming that of anyone, but again, I'm here to actually help you avoid some mistakes and to actually get you to sharpen your skills and to build up your fundamentals and the foundation so that when you reach a higher level, you're not going and asking people, well, how do I actually, pipe content into another command? How do I, compile my own kernel and stuff like that? That's all very, very important stuff. Right, so I've compiled a list of resources that I would absolutely recommend to anyone, and I would recommend to myself if I was getting into the industry. So let me just take you through them. Now, of course, as I said, the primary or the old answer that I would have given is perfectly fine. If you want to learn Linux, use Linux. Use it, as much as you can, and you learn a lot about it. But there are resources that can help you understand it better and can also teach you a few things that you might have missed out on. And one of these websites that is an absolute, godsend is Linux Journey, and that's under linuxjourney.com. Now, I was made aware of this website about 1 year ago, and it's absolutely fantastic. I mean, what a resource this is, and it's absolutely free. So it essentially takes you through all the various important topics in regards to learning Linux, and it's sorted out in, three levels. So you have your Grasshopper, and you have your Journeyman, and then Networking Nomad, and of course other guides and tutorials are being added frequently. This is a more of a documentation page, but my God, man, what a fantastic resource this is for beginners. And of course, I had to share this with you guys. And then of course at the bottom you have recommended resources. So these are all the books that are highly recommended, and they are recommended. I have actually gone through three of these books. More specifically, the What Every Super User Should Know, that's how Linux works. And then the Unix and Linux System Administration Handbook and the Linux Command Line and Shell Scripting Bible. Now, it is to be noted that I'm not going to be touching upon certifications. I'm just covering how to learn Linux. So again, it's sorted out in terms of, getting started. So if we get started with the Getting Started guide, it'll take you through the history of Linux. And then at the right here, you have your exercises, right? So it'll give you additional reading, or it then gives you the quiz here where you can actually answer it. And what this does is it actually validates your learning. So it actually tests you to see if you're actually reading what it's actually given you to read. So again, in this case, it's telling us who developed the Linux kernel. That's Linus Torvalds, so on and so forth. And then the great thing, it actually explains the differences between all the primary or the most important Linux distributions out there. So for example, if I click on Red Hat Enterprise Linux, it'll tell me who it's developed by and the package management that is used. In this case, you can see it tells us that it uses RPM. The configurability, REHL or Red Hat Enterprise Linux will differ slightly from the Debian-based operating systems, mostly most noticeably in package management. And the use cases, right over here, as described by its name, mostly used in enterprise. So if you need a solid server OS, this would be the good one. You then have Linux Mint. I can click on that. It again tells you it's great for desktop and laptops. Gentoo Linux. Yeah, I definitely recommend installing Gentoo. Gentoo is really, really great. In fact, if you're using Arch, I recommend switching to Gentoo immediately. But that's besides the point. And The two sections that I recommend a lot of you go through are the sections called Text Foo and Advanced Text Foo that actually cover, you know, the text manipulation and navigation utilities like grep, pipe, cat, tail, head, right over here, cut, paste, join and split, sort, the unique command, the word count, grep as well. And then, of course, within Advanced, you have your regular expressions. My God, how important is this? This is like, if you go through this guide, you know, you can comfortably tell me that you know how to use Linux. So it takes you through Vim and also Emacs. If you want to get into Emacs, I know that's a, you know, point of contention there. Right. So these are the basics. So that's the grasshopper level. And then you, if you go to Journeyman, you have your device management, the kernel, which is great. And then you have your init systems, which is great if you want to understand about the various init systems. So it covers sysv, upstart, and systemd. So under the kernel, it takes you through an overview of the kernel, the various privilege levels, the kernel installation, and more importantly, kernel modules and the location, which is a great introduction. As I said, this is not totally comprehensive, but after you go through this guide, you'll have a much better understanding of Linux. You'll be able to navigate it much, much better, much more efficiently. You'll really, really, really learn a lot. And then, of course, my favorite, which is networking, and another area that I recommend you learn, because when you're talking about cybersecurity and Linux or pen testing in Linux, you're going to be dealing with a lot of stuff like DNS, network configuration, subnetting, very important. And then, of course, routing. So I recommend going through this section quite well as well. Now, that's learning Linux, and almost in a theoretical manner. Of course, you can practice, you can actually practice what you're doing or what you're learning from the Linux journey in your terminal, and that's fine. But a great way of validating your knowledge is to actually, you know, to do this in real life, to apply this in, you know, in enterprise environments. But of course, I know that that's not available to everyone. And a great way of validating your knowledge is to actually go through challenges and CTF challenges or war games. And the challenge I recommend is the Over the Wire challenge, and that's under War Games and Bandit. So Bandit is a Linux-based challenge, and it'll actually take you through, or the challenges will involve various utilities that you will have already learned within the Linux journey. And the great thing I like about the Bandit challenges is, again, there are various flags that encourage you to actually keep pushing through all the levels. So you can see it's about 34 levels. And the other great thing about it is actually covers, you know, utilities that you're more likely to use, like Git. So it actually tests your knowledge of Git, how branches work, how tags work, so on and so forth. So highly recommended challenge. It really, really will validate your knowledge of the Linux operating system, and will get you to a competent level. If you are looking for reference videos, we have our playlist called Linux Essentials for Hackers, and I'm not shilling the channel here, I'm not promoting it, but of course, that's the reason we made this. And these are reference videos that you can always return to if you're not understanding a concept and you want a better explanation. And then, of course, we have the Over the Wire Bandit challenges that, again, are reference videos. If you're ever having a problem with the challenge, you can use the videos to learn and then, of course, apply what you're learning. So that's Over the Wire Bandit. And then, of course, you have Linux Survival. Now, Linux Survival is a bit dated, but again, it has the same structure where it gives you challenges and then a terminal where you can actually type it in and validate or solve the challenges that it gives you. So, for example, it sorts it out into, you know, four modules that cover all the, you know, the important commands. So, for example, if I click on manual pages here, for example, I'll just take you through a challenge. So there we are. As you can see, it tells you now it's time to work on a task. The last time you saw your friend Greg, he told you that he had a couple of jokes, etc., etc. The first step is to figure out Greg's ID. So you can go skulking in his home directory. You could discover which command will give you this sort of user information by finding a good Linux book to look through. But fortunately, there's an easier way. The entire contents of your system Linux manual is available online. The command which displays portions of the online documentation is called the man, which stands for manual. So again, it gives you a very good introduction to the man pages. And then, of course, it'll give you the various commands that you can use, and overall a great utility. All of these links will be in the description section. And then when you want to get into bash scripting, which is the obvious logical next step, because it'll of course boost your productivity, the book I recommend going through, which is again rightfully so called the Bible, is Linux Command Line and Shell Scripting Bible. Really, really great stuff in that book. I still, use that book to this day whenever I'm writing my own Bash script. So the Bash guide is fantastic. I actually use it quite a bit nowadays as I'm working on my Bash scripting skills. So it sorts it out into chapters. So you can see, let me just give you a basic introduction here. So this guide is an introduction to basic and advanced concepts of the Bash shell. It teaches both newcomers and longtime users the best, safest, and most robust ways of writing powerful Bash scripts, as well as making efficient and speedy interactive use of the shell. So again, some of it is still under construction. So again, it sorts it out into categories. And of course, you have the I'm done button here, which is a great way of tracking what you're doing. So again, that's still in alpha here. So again, it'll take you through variables. And again, it explains everything really, really well in a very easy to understand way. So that's the Bash guide, and that's at the guide.bash.academy. And those are pretty much all the resources I recommend. If you want to learn how to use Vim, just install it and start using it. There are tons of other, games on online services that can actually teach you, allow you to practice how to use Vim. But using Vim is very, very simple. And again, it is covered here quite a bit under advanced text foo. And hopefully, going through these resources will give you a solid introduction to Linux. And of course, you can build upon that as you move along. And as I said, the reason I make these videos is because they are very, very helpful to anyone who is getting started. And at the beginning, the only thing you need is direction. You don't need hand-holding. You need direction. Once I give you the direction, then you can go down that path and, wherever it takes you, because you're already on that on that path now. So I'm just here to point you into that direction and to give you all the things that you'll need on your journey. So I'll be making more videos like this because I feel that they are helpful to the community at large. And don't worry, I'm going to be making my normal videos, where we cover all the various techniques and, we'll be going through Try Hack Me, Hack the Box, Vuln Hub, etc., etc. So that's pretty much going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please leave a like down below. If you want to support our channel, you can do that on Patreon. And I'll be seeing you in the next video. Peace. I just want to take a moment to thank all our Patreons at patreon.com/hackersploit for all the support. Your support and help is truly appreciated. You keep us making newer and fresher and better content. So I just want to say thank you to all the Patreons. So thank you Murph the Surf, Daniel Bork, Jonathan Kyle, Adam Mack, Jamal Guillory, Dafim Bari, Jeremy Nikolai, Mary Hara, Max Chow, Dustin Umpress, Michael Hubbard, and Jerry Spetz.